this is Jonathan French Guitar, and today's tutorial is Stay True by Mereba. And before we get started, why don't you go ahead and give me a like, a share, a comment, and a subscribe. Let me know in the comments what requests you have for a tutorial. So all tutorial requests, you can go ahead and put those in the comments. And while you're at it, go ahead and feel free to check out my Patreon, and do consider becoming a patron on my Patreon. I'll be posting exclusive content there, lessons that you can only see there. There's earlier content that you get on there. Also, if any content on the channel goes missing, those videos, you can find them still on the Patreon, because sometimes the videos get blocked in different regions, and you know, I have no control over that. However, you can still view those videos on the Patreon, and of course, least of all, it is an opportunity to help support this channel by becoming a valued patron. So let's so before we get into the lesson, I almost forgot. I'm leaving that link to the Patreon in the description of this video. So let's get right into the lesson. Today's lesson is Stay True by Mereba, and this is actually a request from subscriber Lockie6458. I'm sorry if I messed up your name. but I thank you for putting in a request for this song. This is actually a really cool R&B kind of neo soul song. Only two chords, and it's got a cool riff going throughout. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to play that cool riff at the beginning that goes like. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to, with your picking hand, you're going to want to kind of palm mute on the string. So you're going to let that picking hand rest gently on the strings. So you don't want your notes going, you want them to be. Okay, so now we're palm muting, and then we're going to take our first finger, we're going to go to the third string on the ninth fret, and then our third finger, we're going to get that third finger ready to go to the 11th fret on that same string. So 11th fret on the third string. So we're on the third string, and we're going to be going between the ninth fret and the 11th fret, like just like that. Okay, and then we're going to do the same thing on the fourth string. So it's going to be the ninth and 11th fret on the fourth string. So yeah. So first you're going to start off on the third string, 9-11. Yep, and then you're going to go to the fourth string. And then you're just going to go 9-11 on the fourth string. And then back to 9-11 on the third string. So I'm going to play it slow again first. Now faster. That's the intro. Now the chords that you're going to need for the rest of the song are A major 9 and E major 9. So first, how we make that A major 9 is we're going to take our second finger and we're going to put that on the fifth string on the 12th fret. And then our first finger is going to go to the fourth string on the 11th fret. Our pinky is going to the third string on the 13th fret. And our third finger is going to the second string on the 12th fret. You're going to strum from the fifth string to the second string. And if it sounds like that, you're playing it correctly. Then for E major 9, you're going to take your second finger. It's going to go to the fifth string on the seventh fret. First finger is going to the fourth string on the sixth fret. Pinky is going to the third string on the eighth fret. And your third finger is going to the second string on the seventh fret. You're going to strum from the fifth string to the second string. Both of these are the same shape. Both of these chords have the same shape. A major 9, E major 9. Okay, the only difference is just that look where your second finger is supposed to be. So for E major 9, second finger starts off on that fifth string on the seventh fret. A major 9, second finger starts off on that fifth string on the 12th fret. Okay, so we're going to go over the strum pattern for the chord progression for the song. So you start off on A major 9. Play it twice just like that. Go to E major 9 and do the same thing. So, even though for both of these chords, I say just strum from the fifth string to the second string, you have the option to play that open E string. It's going to sound a little pretty in this song. It's going to sound a little bit prettier for the E major 9. Also, you can open up that sixth string and play that. See, that sounds pretty just like that. And that's the song. Have fun. And now we're going to play the riff and the chords in context.
We driving on the west side, 9:45 US should be light. I say alright, that will be delightful. I think I like you, kinda enticing. So you wanna know what it's looking like? That's justified, cause it's been some time. I don't know, no, I don't know. See, I'm hella hip this time. Ain't going down with no shit this time. Cut the bullshit this time. Crazy on some lips, could you kiss me blind? No, no, not this time. See, I'm hella hip this time. Ain't going down with no shit this time. So cut the bullshit this time. Crazy on some lips, could you kiss me blind? No, no, not this. Don't play me like a fiddle. Keep another love with me up in the middle. Keep another love with me, you'll be the middle, no more. all your rhythms long. She hates you like a true one. Yeah, yeah. So
tutorial for the day. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did in fact enjoy this tutorial, please do not hesitate to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead and hit that notification bell. Thank you and have a great day.